Mohammad Irfan. Or has he nicked it? They've all gone up and it's a first baller. Irfan strikes. El Dorado celebration. And he stands tall amongst his team. He's knocked the big one back. Chris Gayle has gone. Brandon King at three. He's in second ball of the match or the innings. And they've all gone up behind and it's a belated half appeal from the bowler. He didn't think there was anything, but they've all gone up behind. And that's Jason Holder at second slip, Ashley Nurse at first and Nick Poran. Goodness me, I wonder whether they might put another slip in for this opening over. Put the pressure on Brandon King. It's coming down from a height from this human skyscraper. Dr. Smith. That's four balls gone. We might even have another slip and a short leg just to finish this opening over. Oh, it's gone over the top of middle. What an over this is. Goodness me, this one has just come back at Brandon King. Top delivery it was, and it went over the top. For that reason, 0 for 1, a brilliant over by Mohammad Irfan. This man, Irfan, 6 dot balls, wicket first ball.
Beautifully bowled.
Nick Poran doesn't keep hold of the ball. That's, it just releases a bit of pressure because Irfan is bowling well here to Brandon King. Brandon King ducks and Poran, all right, yeah, it's gone wide. That's an edge, they have gone up for it and so is the finger. Evan Lewis just stares, he can't believe he's been given out, but the Trident celebrate.
He wasn't happy with this. There was a little bit of a noise, but there's certainly no hesitation from bowler or keeper. The big man is up. He's got his second.
New man is Devon Thomas, and Irfan, his tail is up. Yeah, there's a noise. And it, Ian Bishop shakes his head alongside me.
Well, look, whatever he stood there, whatever the disappointment, it has to be about his poor run of form, because I wouldn't blame the umpire for that. That looked as though he bottom-edged that through to the keeper, judging by the sequence of noise and visual.
Oh, dear, what a great start. This is by Irfan. 3 gone, 7 for 2. Irfan will continue. 2 for naught in 2 overs he's got. A slip and a gully as well. Devon Thomas is in. That's his third delivery. He's not off the mark. And it's Ashley Nurse's at slip.
But he's in a sweet spot right now. I'm sure there'll be genuine consideration to bowl him out here. He's into his third over. What would you do, Ian Bishop?
Tell you at the end of this all.
Your captain, you need to make a call right now. Get your head around the balance of your attack.
Ball him out.
Forced it out of me, didn't
I? Look, you do.
Ball him out 100%. Because wickets now are worth their weight in gold. If you can get wickets now, and he's looking like he's going to take a wicket every single ball, is where you're going to win the game. There's no point saving him for six balls in the middle of the innings because the game may have got away from him. You've got him on the canvas, bury them.
I'll ask you another one. Would you put another slip in? It's gone past the bat. So often. There's another one. No, this time Mohammad Irfan was not so convinced, but he's beaten the bat. He's bowled 16 deliveries. He's got two for naught. And he keeps going past the outside edge of the bat. Why wouldn't you have another slip in there?
Well, you asked me the question about would I have another slip. I'd probably say to you no, but what I would do is have gully in a second slip. When you have extra pace and bounce, you're more likely going to get a thinner edge than a thicker edge. So second slip's got more value to me.
There's almost the start of another celebration from Pura.
Tempted to go the other way, tempted to get another slip. Because the reason I like the gun is because of that same bounce that we talk about. Easily. With bounce and pace and pitch, glove and lob to gully. So I want a man in, maybe I take one from the offside, open up a gap and get him into second slip and keep the gully and add that second slip.
I'd agree with that. You could even consider taking the short fine leg, 45, put him at second slip.
Brilliant. Three overs, two for naught from Irfan. It's 13 for two. Irfan's going to bowl his fourth and final over.
It wasn't an argument. We both agreed he should bowl out. It was
I'm
an
not
agreement.
Sure.
It wasn't an argument.
I'm fishing for one.
You wouldn't like to see a West Indian argument, I tell you what.
Well, Brandon King is swinging away like a rusty gate and there's absolutely nothing happening. What a spell this is.
Only one wicket coming into this game. None for 50 in his second game. But boy, has he got things right today. Still no runs. He's been hit off his bowling. He's got two key wickets. He is up and about. The amount of play and misses too. Just keep rising.
The thing about pitches like these, Mel, folks at home, I always say it, when you get on to pitches with this bounce and pace, your guys fielding down at third man has to think that this is a catching position. When a batsman is slashing like this, Wahab has got to be on the alert. The guy at fine leg should always be alert.
Now, Mohammad Irfan has delivered 20 deliveries. They haven't scored off him yet, and he's decided to change his trajectory to come round the wicket. I suppose he's as frustrated as everyone, as anyone, because he wants to either hit the stumps or just get another wicket, because King has flailed away and still is. This is becoming a bit of a show. Brandon King just cannot cope.
I think the other thing in Irfan's mind as well is that Brandon King's been backing away to give him some pace, whether or not he wants to actually target him a little bit more, coming in at the body. That one's actually hit the pitch and held up. So King needs to find a way at the moment. The way in which he's doing things is not working. What's going to go through his mind? What can Thomas add to this equation to try and find a way for him to get into his innings?
How does a yorker look here, given that he's tailing away?
He's coming back over. You might not see the yorker, but it'd be pretty handy delivery. It's amazing. Right, okay, now how many balls have gone? Four balls have gone. Four dots in this last over now. The least number of runs in a four-over spell in the CPL is three. Sohail Tanveer on this ground last year took 5 for 3. Sunil Narine has gone for three, naught for three against the Hawksbills. And Shoaib Malik took 1 for 3 in Antigua against the Hawksbills. run's gone for naught. He's got something on it. Right, five dot balls. Nobody. The two is the fewest runs conceded off four overs. Two in T20 history. That's not just CPL. Two runs. So this ball could be history in the making. Could be. And Brandon King will be part of that history because he's contributed to it largely. It's still a history. It's still history that's been made. Four overs, two for one from Mohammad Irfan. That's a tall story if ever you told one. 18 for two.